please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. We have about 40 seconds, so let's get some F&O strategies in. Yogesh Mehta of Motilal, Oswal, patiently waiting by. Good morning, Yogesh. Thanks a lot for joining in. What are you trading today?
Latha, since we will be having ahead of event, probably we may see Bank Nifty gap opening on a downside. So probably 11,400 is on the higher side, Nifty resistance level, and 11,450, and 11,330 and 11,250 are the respective levels. Okay. Though on the individual stock specific, we have buy recommendations wherein TVS Motor, since last 3 days, it is showing a positive momentum. Last closing was 583. Keeping a small stop as of 573, target could be in the range of 602. The other one is CESC, which is holding on to their, it is 980 and 1040 range, and keeping a stop loss of 980, initiate a buy, and target could be in the range of 1040. And the third one which we are recommending is UBL. It is very much on a positive territory and holding on to the gains with the 1320 to 1330 level. Closing is 1325, keeping a stop loss of 1298. Target could be in the range of 1380. This is a bit of a positional 4 to 5 days trade.
Okay, Yogesh, thanks a lot for that. Well, the pre-opening rates are kicking in right now. Bank of Baroda is showing you the first downtick, down almost about 10-odd%, perhaps on expected lines. Keep an eye out on a couple of these other PSU banking names as well, but Bank of Baroda stands out as far as the underperformance is concerned. Corporation Bank is up 20% right now, and so is IOB. 14% higher on IOB and Corporation Bank up 20%. Well, these rates are all over the place for now because it's just the first initial tick in pre-opening. We'll wait for them to settle. The Sensex and the Nifty are indicating that the start will be a tad bit in the green. So these are the first ticks that are kicking in.
Rupees 55. So that's not a bad start at all. Yesterday was 51 close. So the dollar is more expensive by about 4 paise. In percentage terms, that doesn't work out too much. 0.01% because... most like the ringgit, rupiah, many of them have been a little worse off. So I wasn't expecting a very positive start, but this is absolutely flat. Nothing to worry just yet on the rupee. But I think Bank of Baroda will be the one that should be on your radar. At the moment, 9% down, I mean 10% down on that stock. I don't know if there is a trade on Vijaya yet.
It's up 20% in pre-opening.
Vijaya?
Yeah.
No, that's I think someone on dope. 20%. They are the guys who have lost the most. Okay. Well, with that, let's get more strategies in. We have Prakash Divan joining us now. Good morning, Prakash. Well, first up, what do you do with DOB and Vijaya now?
What do we do? So if you are a Vijaya Bank shareholder, of course, it's a tough call. It's a bad situation to be in. But my sense is, Latha, the BOB stock might not eventually get smacked so badly on the back of this development. And of course, more details awaited on the swap ratio, whether there's going to be some money coming in. So I think the initial reaction, if it is negative for BOB, I would probably see that as an opportunity for a lot of people to buy in. But you know, you need to give it some time. Vijaya Bank, you just need to bite the bullet and book that loss.
Okay, bite the bullet and book that loss. Dena Bank, by the way, is also up about 20-odd%. Well, we'll wait for the bank rates to settle. The other stock that's looking good is HUL. In pre-opening, it's one of the big Nifty gainers, up, I think, almost about 1.5% or so. Prakash, hi, good morning. They had an analyst meet yesterday where they spoke about, you know, stable pricing, 7-8% volume growth, a good Q2, etc. HUL is down 10% this month. You think it's a good time to buy?
Sonia, not yet. You know, if you read between the lines, what they're very clearly indicating is that the volume growth of 5-7%, which could happen, is going to be on the basis of you know, home care products. Now, that's not something that is such a big growth area. That's not something that leads to margins, even if volumes were to come in. And you know, remember the grammage, the base effect of the grammage increases that they had last year is going to be away now. So I think HUL would be a bit stressed going forward. It'll be the smaller FMCG plays which have got ignored in this large cap rally that we've seen, which could probably play catch up. And then with rural spends, election year, all of that works better for low price ticket product manufacturers rather than HUL, which is slightly premium now. So I would get in a hurry to buy HUL. I would believe it would probably lose a bit more ground, and then maybe you know you could evaluate.
Okay, Prakash, good morning. In the near term, you reckon the move on IT is done or is there still more to go in the mid-cap IT?
No, I think, Anuj, let's look at what's driving IT now is not just, you know, as I told last time also, the currency benefit is probably, you know, more back-ended for this quarter. I mean, you know, you might probably have most of September being a good quarter, but given the hedge positions that most players have been used to continuing with, I don't think the dollar is the reason why these IT companies look promising. The answer is yes, they still look good because the kind of growth that you would see in the US markets is going to be very strong. You know, there's a structural change out there that's happening and there's actual growth coming. Look at the acquisitions which some of these guys have started announcing. This happened about 3 years back when there was expectation of growth. So my sense is IT is still a very good spot to be in. Pharma might have issues which should be stock specific, company specific, but IT as a trend will be much better for especially the mid-cap ones.
Okay. Well, Prakash, we speak a great deal about all these big stocks, but anything in the mid-cap space that we are ignoring now? I mean, as a sector, it's not, of course, done as well as the big boys. But just train our eye to something that's attracting you.
Certainly. When the BOVs of the world and the banks of the world take away the limelight, remember, sugar happened quietly. It kind of, you know, crawled upon us and then was vying for attention. And certainly that breakout, 45% in 2 days. I'm not saying that's valid, that's fundamentally driven. But expectations are building up that fertilizer could be the next area of promise. You could probably look at some of those, especially where the government has a big influence in terms of the growth trajectory. So I would believe a GSFC possibly or one of these, you know, nationally owned, I mean, the government owned fertilizer companies could be looked at. And I was talking about FMCG with Sonia on the HUL side, Latha. And my sense is, you know, the smaller companies like Bajaj Corp and all, which have come up with very decent numbers, still look promising. They've not rallied. They've not kind of gone out of whack in terms of valuations. And finally, when people get money, it's going to be spent on low price point items first rather than the big things. So I would continue to buy the ignored. I like the word ignored that you mentioned. And that's exactly the pocket that you need to look at and then rejig your portfolio, maybe within the same sector. But yes, there is opportunity in some of these.
Okay. Wow, there is a big rally in the bond market. It's opened at 8.07. Of course, even yesterday, there was a bit of a rally in the sense it closed at 8.1 from 8.17 in the morning. There's a further rally now. And that may bring some cheer, maybe for the day, maybe for the moment, maybe for an hour, to the NBFC stocks as well, that have been at the receiving end of higher cost of capital. But at the moment, the Nifty is showing a flat trend and the Nifty Bank is the one that's down 0.25%.
And, you know, the sugar space is rallying once again. I mean, we spoke about that. The last few days have been very good for sugar. Today, once again, Rana Sugar, Dwarikesh, Bajaj Hindustan, all of them, Dhampur, up about 7 to 10 odd percent. Prakash, you did speak about fertilizers. I wanted your thoughts on sugar. But before that, Manisha Gupta, our commodities editor, has been waiting by. So let's go straight to her and find out what's the latest update in the commodity arena. Hi, Manisha. Good morning.
Hi, Sonia. Thank you so much for that. Well, it is 0.5% down in the crude oil prices, and that's after you have seen the trade war concerns in the global markets escalate, and that really seems to be clouding the demand outlook after US has put in a 10% tariff on $200 billion worth of Chinese goods. The markets are bracing themselves for a retaliation from China, to which US says that if there is a retaliation from China, then they would be looking at a third phase of US tariffs to be put on Chinese goods, this time around $267 billion worth of that. So the tensions really seem to be heating up, and that has pulled many of the commodity prices on the lower side. For the crude, it also is about the U.S. shale output, which is expected to increase to 7.8 million barrels per day by October. It also is about statements from Russia saying that they are willing to talk to U.S. on increasing output or balancing the markets. It is only Iran's sanctions which is supporting the prices right now. Also, the Chinese housing data is the best in the last 2 years, and that in turn also has been a supportive factor for the metal prices today.
Okay, Manisha, thanks a lot for that analysis. Bank of Baroda is still down about 10%, and of course, Dena is still up 20%. Now, Vijaya has settled. The other weaker
Canada is the weaker fellow.
Canada is the weaker fellow. And I think even Indian Bank perhaps would be the one where there could be some impact.
Yes, that's it is. Of course 2% down.
The strongest of the lot. So that's where the SBI has already absorbed a lot of its own subsidiaries. So I don't know if there's a fresh negative on SBI, but just pull out that stock as well.
It's flat.
It's flat. 63 points lower is what you have on the Nifty Bank because of the pressure on some of these banks. And of course, the Nifty is up about 4 points in pre-open. Ashwani, if we open here, what would be the first trade? And in terms of your 9-10 call, what would that be?
See, basically on the banks, you'll be very close to recent lows of about 26,720. So this sort of news flow, if we are able to survive this 26,720 today, could be a good day for private banks to come in. Okay. So given the sideways nature of the market, maybe at those lows a trade on the Bank Nifty on the other side, which is the long side, may tend to work out. But overall, this sort of open, I don't think you would be doing much. Let the Bank Nifty get to the lower boundary. In terms of 914, Havels is a buy with a stop of 660, target of 678.
You said it's a sideways market. You can make it sideways with a capital S, actually. In the Nifty, there isn't a single stock which is more than 1% higher and not a single stock which is more than 1% lower. So it's as tight a range as that. Sudarshan, I wanted to ask you, what are the charts of Bank of Baroda telling you?
Oh, even before this, Bank of Baroda was telling us it's going below 100. And now also it's in double digits. We can listen to it and wait, and that event will happen.
Okay. HCL Tech is the other one that you should keep on your radar. The buyback, the 4,000 crore rupee buyback opens today. And, there is an expectation that the promoters are likely to participate in this one. Prakash Diwan, what would your advice be? Give this one a miss or tender in?
No, I think I would. I'm positive on IT. And we've seen the experience from TCS. Of course, that's a different kettle of fish. But I wouldn't tender my shares if I had in HCL Tech. Give it a miss, yeah.
Okay. Today is the entire Reliance ADAG group. I mean, they call them the Reliance group, right?
Yeah.
Their annual general meeting. So just watch out. RCOM, RINFRA, RPOWER, all of them.
Yes, the rupee is recovering, by the way, quite a bit. In fact, it's now at the highest point of the morning. So let's see, along with the fact that, as Latha mentioned, bond yield also seeing a bit of a recovery. Perhaps the start today could be slightly on the upside for all you know with the banks. Of course, there's going to be the overhang on Bank of Baroda, but that's no longer the part of the index or the Nifty at least. So could be quite interesting. Mitesh, your thoughts on market opening, pre-opening, and any interesting stock idea?
Yeah, so I think it's opening pretty flat. I think, as I said, I think unless until we get past 11,430, I won't really be keen to go long. But maybe, in case we get some kind of more bounce during the day, explore shorting on the Bank Nifty. I would still, bet while the rupee's recovered slightly, but I would still bet on exporters. I think the overall value of the rupee is clearly on the lower side. And I think these stocks are clearly showing better chart patterns.
Okay. I just want to point out, yesterday the rupee was boxed between 72.40 and 72.70. Every time it went towards 72.65, there would be some leak. The CBDT will say we have got a lot more direct taxes there are going to be very big import curbs
duty
on five sectors or something like that.
Yes.
And every time it went to 40, there was a huge amount of importer buying. So, this lagged buying of importers who are worried that it might go to 73 is going to keep the pressure and keep the rupee roofed around that 72.40 levels. If that breaks, then let us see where it finds. But at 72.40, it's repeatedly finding buying. It therefore could be a range day. We'll have to wait and see whether there is enough courage to break the range. Mitesh, anything you have observed now for a trade before market starts?
Not much, Latha. As I said, I think I'll keep my focus on mostly on one, exploring short side on the banking side and exporters. I would still want to trade long, but let it open. I think, once we get the rates opening, and I think then we'll be in a much better place to start.
Okay. Well, Prakash, you mentioned the fertilizer stock. So what about sugar? I mean, for a trade, not for an investment, is it still worth a buy?
Yeah, I mean, if you get some respite in this exuberance, which is all across, because you would have to buy companies that actually benefit from two things. One is the ethanol hike, which seems imminent, but you know, all these names that are flying around really don't have the wherewithal to participate in that ethanol story. So be selective. We are Dhampur, take a Dhampur, Balrampur, maybe an EID, but of course, it's the UP mills that are likely to benefit much more. The second is there's some likelihood of an increase in MSP, and that could also you know, be some sort of a discounting that could start happening in the favor of manufacturers. So sugar could be an opportunity, but not today, not now. I mean, it's already rallied 45% 2 days. Give it some space, let it, you know, consolidate. And then, yeah, you could probably look at buying into it, because if the trend starts, Sonia, remember, it's an 18 to 21 cycle. Sugar is really long. Mm-hmm. And then that would give you a significant upside, which would be gradual than what we've seen in the last 2 years.
Ashwini, has Jubilant Food stopped falling?
See, it's early to say that. You know, that is where money is hiding. And if money is coming out, Jubilant may also probably start to buy.